Fergus and Angus.
I'm here, brother.
Is it just me? Or does nobody actually ever die apart from Monroe here? Look, Eleanor was supposed to be dead, but she isn't. Same with Amelia, and honestly, I'm surprised we found you two.
Shut it. One's very weak, the other's barely holding on. We can't move them.
Majesty, it's good to see you. Likewise, pal. How are you feeling?
I'm right. Can't complain. So, this is your wife?
Aye.
Well, thank you, Your Majesty, for helping me recover.
You're welcome.
How's Angus doing?
No, well, pal. He's barely breathing. I'm scared for him, pal.
Have hope, Fergus. What happened?
There was a battle. We rode here to bring back the others, but they were all dead. Then Daniel's men snuck upon us. Angus was the hero and saved your wife.
Come on then, you English bastard!
Angus, watch out!
Get behind me, lass.
Ah, shite.
Well, this didn't go according to plan, did it?
Let's try and move you.
Look at all the blood. Oh, that's coming out of me. That's not good.
Let's get him inside.
Angus, are you awake?
Robert.
We're here, pal. James, Owen, Scott. Some new pals. That's good, sir. How you feeling, Angus?
I'm no feeling no good, pal.
I'm finding it hard to breathe. And I can't even move my legs. It's good to see you all one last time.
Remember what I said a minute ago?
Last time? Come on, pal. I know I'm going to die here. Don't make this any harder, Robert. But when you're a good lad, a young lad, keep your cousin safe. Scott, you're so brave, so brave. Keep up the fight. James, thank you for believing in me. Fergus, you're a mad bastard, you know that? Your Majesty, thank you for doing all you could. Robert, there are no words, my friend. No words. You helped me reclaim my family's lands and my titles. I'm forever in your debt. No, I'm in yours. Your parents would be proud of you, Angus. So proud. Thank you, Your Majesty.
No!
Robert, please calm yourself. Do not let this get emotional.
I won't.
Oh, I love this one.
I'll swim and sail on savage seas, when near a fear of drowning, and gladly ride the waves of life if you will marry me. No scorching sun nor freezing cold will stop me on my journey.
Sorry.
If you will promise me your heart and love.
And love before eternity. tree, and I would keep you from all harm if you would stay beside me.
I have no use for wings of gold. I care not for your poetry. I only want your hand to hold.
I only want you near me to love, to kiss, to sweetly hold for the dancing.
I have missed you, Amelia. Would you like to come home? Be my queen once more. Be a mother to Lucy. Why not? Lucy needs her ma. I need my wife. Scotland needs her queen. You will be fine, sweetheart. I promise you that. And I will be right here with you.
So did she go back with them?
Yes, she did. She reunited with her daughter Lucy, and they became a close family once more. Fergus got treated, and he was brought back to full health. They held a funeral for Angus, and they all moved on with their lives.
Is that it? The end?
No. We still have a way to go, Matthew. 6 months have passed by. It was the day of Amelia's ceremony for coming home and being crowned queen.
How many people are out there?
A lot, darling.
Who's out there?
Everyone!
Robert?
Well, other than the staff, we have a few special guests.
They are?
Well, you know that the Archbishop and Father Angelo are running this ceremony. But we have James, Owen, Scott, Fergus, Lord Duncan, Lord Stuart, Ross, Hamish, Lucy, Jane, and myself. Oh, we have an appearance from Jared.
That's a lot of people.
Aye. You will be fine.
Okay.
Aye, you will be fine. Lucy and I will be sitting on our thrones, and as soon as the Archbishop is done with his part, then you will sit down and it will be time for a feast.
Let's get this over with.
Right, Lucy, let's take our places.
Okay, Dad.
Ladies and gentlemen, my lords, ladies, earls and countesses, before we start the ceremony, I believe that His Majesty the King would like to say a few words. Thank you, Father Angelo. Today is a great day of showing our power and our bonds. My wife Amelia has been home now for 6 months. Please remember how this is an important day for her and all of Scotland. To all of those who would like to say a few words to the new queen after the ceremony, you may approach the throne one at a time. Make sure that you all show due deference Now, without any longer, Archbishop, take her away. Brothers and sisters, prepare yourselves for Her Majesty.
Is Your Majesty willing to take the oath?
I am willing.
Will you maintain and preserve it?
I will.
Anointed with holy oil. Thy head anointed with holy oil. As kings, priests, and prophets were anointed. And as Solomon was anointed king by Zadok the priest and Nathan the prophet, so be thou anointed, blessed, and consecrated queen over the peoples whom the Lord thy God hath given thee to rule and govern in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy.
Amen.
Amen. All hail Amelia, Queen of Scots.
I'm so happy, Robert. Thank you for bringing me home.
I'm so happy that you're happy. I am thankful to God for pointing me in the right direction of finding you once more. Besides, one wee lassie is happy you're home as well. Isn't that right, Lucy?
I've missed you, Mum.
And I've missed you, darling. Both of you.